Hi guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Lisa and I live in Switzerland. This channel is about my life in Switzerland, and in this video, let's see what are the costs of living in Switzerland. So if you are interested to know how much my family spent per month living in Switzerland, continue watching. For this video, I've prepared a short list of things we actually spend money for during the months living in the Canton Zurich. So we are a family of three people, two adults and a small child. Some payments are done per year, but I divided them to get the sum per month for your convenience. So let's see in the end of the video what is the total sum you should have in order to live in Zurich. I have divided all the cost we have per month in three blocks. The first one is the block with expenses that we can't really affect on. The second, which I call it depends, because there we will talk about food, leisure, time, and it all depends. You can actually save some money there if you buy cheaper food, or you could also go out less and then also save some money. And the third block is something like savings, what I say you should have per year for some expenses that we are also going to discuss today. So the first block is about the things, the price of which you can't really affect. And this is first of all your rent. Of course you affect it, but it's only once before you sign the contract, right? And here I should say, so we live in an apartment of 3.5, officially 3.5 room apartment. In Switzerland it's very popular that 3.5 is called a flat where you actually have like two bedrooms, one living room and a kitchen. And because kitchen is kind of connected to the living room, there is no really door between them, that's why it's 0.5. So it's like kitchen is count for half. And I know that this is basically the average price. We are not situated in Zurich, but outside of Zurich. And for 90 square meters flat per month, we pay 2,200 Swiss francs. In the past, we used to rent also an apartment, which was just 105 room apartment. So it was basically just a studio with a kitchen, about 45 square meters, and that apartment cost us 1,200 Swiss francs. If you consider renting like a 4-room apartment or 4.5-room apartment, then the price normally starts about 3,000 Swiss francs per month. But for our total cost calculation, I would count the one we pay for 3.5 room apartment, and that is 2,200 Swiss francs per month. If we talk about electricity for our family and for the flat I've just mentioned, we normally pay per month about 40 francs. As for internet connection, we have a Wi-Fi at home and it cost us about 50 francs per month. Plus, we pay also 30 francs for digital connection. So here in Switzerland you pay to the provider, and that is in our case 50 francs for a good stable internet Wi-Fi connection at home, and also 30 francs you pay anyway is just to connect your device at home. In this price also TV is included. We don't use it actually, but it is included, so you pay for it anyway. Health insurance is another part of course that you can't really affect. I mean, you can change your plan, but it's only once a year. So it all depends, first of all, on the amount of excess that you choose for your plan. But let's count for 300 Swiss francs excess per year. So this is the amount we pay upfront. Let's say if we go to a doctor, we first need to pay this 300, and only after that the insurance will start paying for the cost, apart for other 10% of each bill that the person in Switzerland is anyway required to pay every time. For me, it's difficult to count for this 10%, so I'm not going to include in this calculation, but I would include the monthly payment to the insurance, which is for one adult is 350, and for a child it's about 85. And just to let you know that you don't pay any excess for the child. So for the excess for the child is zero. From the first bill of the year when you go to a doctor with your child, insurance will pay. You will just need to pay 10%. Another two type of insurance that are not an obligation in Switzerland but highly recommended. The first is personal liability insurance, and this costs us about 13 francs per month. And it is very often that you buy this insurance together with the household insurance, and that's what we did. And this household insurance is in addition about 30 francs per month. So what is the difference between these two insurances? I'm not going to go into details, but just to let you know that this personal liability insurance covers the cost. If you accidentally cause the damage to others, then this insurance would pay. And household insurance, you basically insure your stuff at home against theft, against fire or water. The likelihood is not high that you might need this insurance, but I had, unfortunately, some experience, bad experience, but I'll tell in any other videos about it. In Switzerland, you also have to pay tax, which is called Serafe. And this is a tax that nowadays everyone has to pay. But in principle, it refers to the use of the internet and TV and radio. In the past, the situation was the following. If you don't have internet, TV or radio at home, or you don't have a car, so you are not able to use it, you could avoid paying these taxes. But nowadays, it's an obligation for everyone, so everyone has to pay. And it makes additional 30 francs per month. So continue the topic of taxes, let's talk about car. So if you have a car, of course it all depends on the size of your car, etc. But so we have a small car, and our tax for the car is about 16 francs per month. I have liability insurance for the car, of course, because it's mandatory, but also I have a full casco, and this makes me paying around 100 francs. Swiss francs per month for the service and maintenance. So if I estimate, it means for me, like once a year I do the maintenance and twice I have to change the wheels, and it adds with additional 70 Swiss francs per month. Now let's slowly move to the second block of the cost that I call the cost that you can actually affect on. Of course, you can also affect on the car. You can sell it if you want, or you just don't buy it. But just in case you have it, you need the gasoline, right? And it all depends how much you travel. For us, on average, we pay for gasoline and parking places, which are, by the way, quite expensive in Switzerland. In addition, about 100 Swiss francs per month. If you don't use the car, but you wondering how much public transport costs, we are not using it at the moment, but in the past we used a lot. It's, by the way, really good. So if you need a ticket that would be valid for all trains, buses, even ships in the Canton Zurich, then per month you should expect pay around 250 Swiss francs. As for grocery store and just some basic things you need on your daily basis, I would say between 800 and 1000 is an average you should count for. So for this calculation, I would use 800 Swiss francs per month, because this is the average cost we have on our monthly basis. But as you will see in my coming videos, it really depends where you buy, where you do your grocery store. Because also many people, including us, sometimes go to Germany to buy some stuff. Then it's becoming cheaper. Or on the other hand, even through the Switzerland, there are different shops where you can do your grocery shopping, like Aldi, Lidl, which are less expensive. On the other hand, we also have Lobos, where you could also buy some food, but it will be the most expensive one. The way how you spend your free time and what are you doing on the weekend also differs between families a lot. I would take an average sum, so I would count for this review 400 Swiss francs per month. For you to get a feeling like to go once to the restaurant would be around 100 Swiss francs on average. Nowadays, since we are more cooking at home and all the restaurants are closed, you just can order the delivery to your place. To some extent, you can save on this point. Another massive part that requires a lot of money from you if your child goes to the daily care. So, till the age of 4 or 5, you should be ready to pay around 2,500 Swiss francs for the daily care of your child monthly. And this is what I'm also going to count to make the estimate of how much does it cost living in Switzerland per month. If you sum up everything I've just mentioned till now, then you should get around 7,500 Swiss francs per month. But as I said in the beginning, we also have another block of cost that would be nice to have on your saving account, for example. And this money goes to pay the excess of your health insurance, for example, or the excess of other insurances, because, you know, like, for example, if you have a case that is covered by car insurance, for instance, with a full casco, I have to pay 800 Swiss francs per case anyway. So it would be nice to have this money reserved. Or the same thing happens with personal liability insurance or household insurance. In case of a case, I also contribute with 200 Swiss francs. It means if I count twice for 300 Swiss francs for an excess of a medical insurance, and then twice with 200 Swiss francs for personal liability insurance and once for household insurance, and also add 800 Swiss francs for car insurance, then it means that I have to have additional 1,000 Swiss francs per year, assuming that every case of the insurance would happen only once. Well, it's better it doesn't happen at all, but just in case, additional 3,000 Swiss francs on your saving account would be nice to have. So, summing up, what cost of living you should expect per month in Switzerland? So, on my experience living in the Canton Zurich, per month for a family of three, living in a 3.5 apartment, having a car, and they also count with 1 abo for public transport for the whole Canton Zurich area, I get 7,500 Swiss francs. So, the question might arise, what are the salaries? If you want to know the salaries, here is the link to one of my previous videos. Please go and check it out, how much you can earn in Switzerland. To estimate basically what you could save or not, depending on the position you are working. So thanks for watching this video till the very end. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it before, and leave the comment. What other kind of videos would you like me to make for you? See you in the next video very soon. Bye bye.